Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You're still watching Africa Today live on Nile TV International, and we're glad to be joined here by Ambassador Ahmad Haggag, former Secretary General of the African Society. Good afternoon, sir, and thank you for
Good
joining
afternoon.
Us. Sir, of course, we're going to be talking about the delegation of Ghana received by President Sisi. President Sisi received on Sunday a delegation led by Victor Guihou, former foreign minister and personal envoy of the president of Ghana. How do you view the historical ties between the two countries, Egypt and Ghana?
It goes back to many centuries ago. I met several years ago a very prominent Ghanaian professor who claimed that some tribes in Ghana, their origin dates from the pharaonic types, mm-hmm. and their languages have some many pharaonic words. Mm-hmm. Anyhow, in recent history, Ghana and Egypt were very close, especially during the presidency of President Kwame Nkrumah, who established the new independent country of Ghana, which was under British colonialism. And President Nkrumah was a frequent visitor to Egypt, and he married an Egyptian lady, Fatma Nkrumah, Tahiya Nkrumah, and his family has a son now, prominent Egyptian journalist, who married an Egyptian also, and he works in Al Ahram Weekly, and his daughter resides now in Ghana, and one time she was a contender for the president to be the post of president of Ghana. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of Ghanaian students in Egypt, and Ghana is a prominent country in the African Union and before in the OU, and a leader of West African states. And it is characterized now by the smooth transition of power. That's why the former president of Ghana congratulated the new president very smoothly. Since 1992, it is known of one of the stable countries, the most stable countries in Africa itself. Mm-hmm.
Right. Guihou conveyed the greetings of the new president of Ghana, Nana Addo, who was inaugurated just 2 days ago.
Yeah.
And Egypt participated in the inauguration ceremony by former Prime Minister Brahim mm-hmm. Mahlab. How do you see this, and how do you comment on the ceremony of the inauguration of the president of Ghana?
I think it's a good gesture from President Sisi to send a very high official who is well known in Africa since he was chairman of the Arab contractors, which are constructing roads and buildings in Africa. And also the new president of Ghana, Mr. Addo, was careful that one of the first countries he contacted after his inauguration was Egypt. I think that he would like to consult with President Sisi about the forthcoming African Union summit, mm-hmm. end of this month in Addis Ababa, mm-hmm. and also to revive the and intensify relation between Egypt and Ghana, especially in the economic field. Ghana is a leading figure, as I mentioned, in the African Union, and have a command in the authority in this organization.
Mm-hmm. Right. We're going to move on to another very important visit, also by an African official to Egypt. Congo Brazzaville foreign minister met with Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry also on Monday during his visit to Egypt. How strong are the relations between the two countries, in your opinion?
Also, Congo Brazzaville is a rather small country in West Africa, in Central Africa, but it's very active politically and economically. And they have a resident embassy here in Cairo, and Egypt has, since the independence of Congo Brazzaville, has a resident embassy in Brazzaville. And we have a system of periodic consultation between the two foreign ministries and the leadership of the two countries. Mm-hmm. President Sassou Nguesso is one of the leaders who always consult with the leadership in Egypt about political development in the OU and after that in the African Union. And I think also, similarly like Ghana, they would like to consult with Egypt in the forthcoming African Union visit, but the purpose is to invite Egypt to attend the African group on Libya, which will be held in soon, since the African Union wanted to be involved in the development in Libya. Mm-hmm. It's a difficult situation in Libya, but Africa is trying to be involved in the development in this country.
Right, and moving on to Libya, Arab League envoy to Libya, Salah al-Din Jamali, visits Cairo on Monday to meet with Foreign Minister Sameh Shoukry to discuss the Libyan crisis. How do you see the importance of this visit, and how do you assess the situation, the current situation in Libya?
I think this is a proof that the Arab League is involved in the developments in Libya, and I think they will attend the forthcoming meeting of the African Union group of countries concerned with Libya situation. There is a lot of developments between Egypt, Algeria, and Tunisia now in order to push the conflicting parties to come to confirm a unified government for Libya, agreed upon by all institutions in Libya. But unfortunately, still there is a lot of factions who refuse to recognize the parliament in Tobruk, eastern Libya. Mm-hmm. But we try to reconcile all those factions. Libya now, unfortunately, after being very rich, it is now borrowing money from outside, and its exports of oil has been dwindling. But we hope that the people of Libya will come to the conclusion that it is their country. They have to guard the security of this country, to have to limit the influence of armed groups which are bringing havoc in different parts of Libya. Mm-hmm. We have seen that the Daesh group has been expelled after a very long fight, mm-hmm. which resulted in a lot of killings, not only among the Daesh people, but also from the Misrata group, which has been dealing with them.
Mm-hmm. And sir, how do you see Egypt's foreign policy with regards to African countries?
I think it is all those visits is a testimony of the increasing activity of Egyptian diplomacy in Africa. And we have been now have relation with almost all the members of the African Unions. We have very good relations now. And we have the biggest number of African embassies anywhere in Africa. Mm-hmm. So we are in good terms. Mm-hmm. Africa still have problems, but there are bright spots like the elections in Ghana, which is a neighboring country to one of your reports about the situation in Gambia, where the former president, after conceding defeat, he changed his mind and he wanted to stay in power.
Mm-hmm. Right. So how do you think we can further enhance our relations with our neighboring African countries in terms of economy, trade, not only on the political level?
I say economic is very important, but not less important is the culture ties. Mm-hmm. Many African countries don't know about Egypt enough. We have used our culture ties not only through scholarships, mm-hmm. thousands of African students are studying in Egypt, but we have to use films, translation of books, both ways. We in Egypt, we don't know enough about literature in Africa.
Right, Ambassador Ahmad Haggag, former Secretary General of the African Society, many thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Dear viewers, with this we wrap up this edition of Africa Today. Many thanks for watching and stay tuned for more coming up here on Nile TV International.